Hi everyone, thanks for watching Pfaff YouTube. Today we are shining the spotlight on Audi, and not only just Audi, but the RS and the sport line behind Audi. I'm here with Elijah Shaw, and we are here at Pfaff Audi in Vaughan. Elijah, we have some really great cars to show, a full lineup. What are we gonna see today?
Yeah, so today what we're gonna feature is some of our RS models, as well as our S model SUVs, getting everybody ready for summer, getting excited. Now's the time where people are starting to slowly pull out their cars. So I think it'll be something exciting to show a lot of those Audi fans, Audi customers, just what we here do at Pfaff, as well as Pfaff Tuning, especially with me being the RS Sport rep. I kind of get free range to have some fun with some cars, make them a little bit different, but still give customers, you know, a reliable car that they can drive every day that's still going to be fun, as well as practical.
Let's get started. Our first car that we will be taking a little look at is the RS5 here, stunning. Elijah, this is really like your two-door sports car, right?
Yeah, so this is gonna be our coupe. This is a 2021 Audi RS5 coupe. This one is finished in black optics. What's really nice about this car is we had a little bit of fun with it. We've got this car lowered by our other division called Pfaff Tuning. We've put some 5mm spacers on there, and we actually did a front to back exhaust from AWE, which maybe we can open up for you guys at the end of the video. What's really nice about this car, it's not overly spec'd. You have the red brake calipers, which really look good on the white. When we move into the interior of the car, what you're really going to notice is that it has that nice black and red stitching with the Alcantara inside as well, which looks really sharp.
Wow,
they've done a nice job.
And the RS line, is it, there are definite ways to tell those cars apart, not only from the exterior but interior details, like the quilted leather, right?
Yeah, so one thing that you'll notice that'll set an RS car apart from an S car, number one is the octagon stitching. So you'll notice this car is black leather finished with a red stitch with the octagon stitching throughout the seats, which look really sharp. It's also finished with the dry carbon. You can still get carbon in the S cars, but with this RS car particularly, it is a dry carbon with the Alcantara wheel. Another thing that is actually really sets the RS cars apart is the honeycomb grille. They have put it into our regular A5s, but now it's a little bit different for the RS cars. Very minimal to the eye, but you have to really take a look at it to notice it, but still a really sharp car.
And you mentioned black optics, which I know means a couple of styling changes, right?
Yeah.
I think the grille obviously is the first time you see that black optics right off the hop.
Yeah, so what that does is it really eliminates, when you go with black optics, eliminates all the chrome on the vehicle on the outside.
Yeah.
It really gives you that high gloss black finish, which looks really, really sharp. On this one, it stands out the most because it is a white car. It looks really good. You'll see that black optics finish throughout the mirrors as well, which looks really good. And we finished this car with a 20% tint just to keep that whole darker theme going of the black and white and giving you a lot of contrast, which is really, really nice.
That contrast is totally evident here against the white. I think that was a good call. It looks amazing.
Yeah.
And then you wanted to show something on the rear.
Yeah, so the exhaust is a full front to back from AWE. It's actually still finished with the high gloss black finish as well. Just keeping that theme going with the car.
Yeah.
Again, done by our team at Pfaff Tuning. We also have the black emblems on this car, which look really sharp. So you'll notice the RS5 emblems are in the black as well, just to keep it going, keep that theme throughout the car. So I think it's a really fun coupe sports car. If you're looking for that coupe to have fun in the summer, good power, sounds nice, and still practical as an everyday car. So
for
I think
sure.
That's really, really nice.
Where are we going next our
next,
little tour?
Next, we're moving to our SQ7. Our SQ7 is gonna be Audi 7-seater.
Yeah.
We did not have an SQ7 before. It was evident in Europe where they had it in a TDI, but now it is here in Canada, in North America, in a gas engine, which is really, really nice.
Okay.
This car is finished in Daytona Gray, which is actually a very popular color for us here from Audi. One thing you will notice is the black optics again, which we've done with this car, as well as the red brake calipers. This car is finished with the air suspension as well, which is really, really nice. Just letting it sit really nicely. which I really like.
So beautiful. We have to show the inside, guys, because if you like that pop of red in your sports SUV, here it is.
Yeah, so this one's finished in the RS red interior. The RS red is nice because it's not a overly aggressive red. It's almost like a maroon finished with the gray stitching, which gives it a really nice contrast when you look through the video. So it looks really sharp. You can see the difference in the colors and everything like that, especially with the gray and the RS red. It looks really, really sharp. So I think they've done a great job still giving you those really sporty seats, as well as the adjustability of moving the seats forward and back for whoever's sitting in the back seat. Especially, it just gives you a great family vehicle that I think is still fun to drive and looks very cool.
I was gonna say that. I think for anybody who is looking for more space and they do have family, cottaging, all of that, this car, you don't have to sacrifice the love of driving and power.
No. Like a lot of people that have families, they're going up to the cottage, they're going away. I think this car is the right car for them. You know, if they want something that's still very fun, and say they don't have a sports car or they have a bigger family, you know, and they just want to have something where they can still get that practicality with fun. And I think the SQ7 is a prime example of that for a seven seater.
And I've noticed that it has certain details like the front sort of flared.
Right? Yeah. So with the SQ7, it's a little bit more aggressive than your regular Q7. Your front end seems a little bit more aggressive.
Yeah.
Dimensions wise, it's the same width as a regular Q7. It's just design cues that you'll see throughout the bumpers to change it up quite a bit. We've had a lot of attention on.
Yeah.
Beautiful car. Not much more we can say. It's really beautiful. It is a five-seater, but it's a big five-seater. It's still very sporty.
Right.
This one, we kept that theme, right? That black and white theme.
Love that.
The black optics. This one was done by Pfaff Tuning as well, actually.
I was just going to say that. What did Pfaff Tuning do to this car to make it a little bit different?
So this one is actually on lowering links. And what it will do is allow the car to sit a little bit lower than factory. Right now we do have it sitting at, you know, respectable drive height, but it does sit a few millimeters lower than this, where the wheels look like they're about to tuck inside the fenders, but not just quite. The wheels were painted and powder coated in a high gloss black finish, where we've taken off the tires, powder coated them the proper way, and then remounted the tires. This would be another great example of, you know, a high power SUV that's still fun, but is, you know, still respectable. It's not like you're moving up to the RSQ8 where you're going with that 600 horsepower.
Still, what are we at in this one?
We're at 500, so 500 is still 500. Great, I think. I think it's perfect.
That's amazing. And then compare it to the SQ7.
Yeah, so if I'm comparing this and the SQ7, the one thing I will say is that this one is meant to look a little bit more sleek, a little bit more coupe design.
Right.
And it is a big five-seater. So if you are looking for that space, you're still going to get that space in the SQ8, which I think is really nice. You still have trunk space. It doesn't look like it's that big, but it's actually surprising.
It is surprising. Yes. Okay. Love those SUV offerings. And then I think we're going to go to a wagon, classic wagon from Audi. This is the RS6. Such a stunning car for so many reasons.
Yeah.
Let's start off by the back. Check out the tailpipes there.
Oh yeah, it's awesome. This car we've done a few videos on, gets quite a bit of attention.
Yeah.
It's been a hard car to get. It's now here, still a very hard car to get. This one, obviously, if you've seen previous videos from us, this was the same car. This car is our demo car, so it has been lowered. It has been put on with spacers just to give that car that final finish. We find a lot of our customers, when they do get RS6s, they do like it just because it gives it that more aggressive feel and look as well. This one, same color as the SQ7, Daytona gray, just because you can't really go wrong. And then obviously the black optics. So looks really good.
Let's take a look at the front of this car. Traditionally, wagons, I mean, you're getting the same space as you are in an SUV.
Correct.
But it's a completely different look, right?
Yeah, so if you didn't want an SUV,
yeah.
The RS6 is perfect.
Yeah.
It is practical. It has lots of room. It's very cool looking. And you can put your family in there, go to the cottage, go to hockey, go to baseball, whatever your kids are doing. You will have that room, which is great. It gives you that practicality of an SUV in a sedan format, which I really, really like.
And Elijah, we saved arguably the best and most special car for last. This is a throwback. Tell us about this RS4.
Yeah, so this is a 2007 Audi RS4. This is a very beautiful car. I would say this is one of my favorite cars that Audi has designed. The V8, the 4.2 liter. It honestly, I would say for some, is one of the best cars that Audi has ever produced. Very well thought out. Every little minute detail was noticed on this car, which I really, really like.
It's a manual transmission.
It V8 is a manual engine. Transmission. 6-speed, which is awesome. You don't see those anymore. Everybody wants to use paddles, but for us here, this was something we had to put in the video. It was the last of the manual cars, which is really nice.
Yeah.
When you move into the inside, it has that beautiful piping along the seats, which looks really, really sharp, and still gives you that nice RS-S design with the carbon inlays, which you notice a lot of the other cars took from cars such as these.
It's just stunning and so well maintained. This is our CEO's car and he takes such pride in it.
Yeah, this would, I would say, would be one of his, on his top list of pride and joys. This car is very special to him and it's very special to Audi, especially Pfaff. For us, when you see this car, you get to see a lot of the design cues that all the new cars come with, including the big flares on the fenders. And even just the way the design is done throughout the trunk lid, you'll notice that nice little flare that looks really sharp.
This little scoop at the back?
Exactly, yeah. The scoop. And then obviously the big thing is the exhaust. You'll notice that oval design from this car, which, you know, has kind of started a trend for all the RS cars. If you look at all of them, they have that nice oval exhaust. And that's something that's definitely very reminiscent of Audi Sport and the RS cars.
And this car in general is very rare. I don't know if people realize. A lot of Audi fans know when they see this car.
Exactly. So to the natural eye, a lot of people may not notice it, but a lot of the Audi customers, we actually had one gentleman just come in and said to him, he saw this in the showroom and said, this is hands down the best car that Audi has ever made. So it just speaks volumes about the car. Just that little bit of attention, if you notice. Often you'll notice, if you notice them on the street, the one thing that will stand out is, why is it so wide? Well, you know what, with the RS4s and a lot of the RS cars, that's one thing that really sets them apart from all the other cars in the Audi lineup, is how aggressive they look, how wide the fenders are. And it's something that, you know, has continued on all the way up to now in 2021.
Thank you so much for that insight on all of the RS cars and the SQ8 and SQ7. Fantastic. If you have any questions, everybody, we would love to hear from you. Just comment below. And we really, truly hope you enjoyed this feature and that it's getting you excited for spring and summer driving.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited. I can't wait to bring out my car. And I'm sure a lot of people can't wait to bring out theirs, especially with summer coming around the corner. So thank you for tuning in, and come see us at Pfaff Audi Vaughan if you're looking for an RS car.
Thanks, everyone.